Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this card, and this is the Christmas collage background stamp. Can you see the shimmer paint on there? I just love this card. It opens up just like this, and then I made a smaller version like that. Okay, so I'm going to get started. We're going to use Crumb Cake cardstock, and this measures 4 1/4 by 11, and you're going to score it at 5 1/2. Okay, the way that I apply ink to my background images is I use a brayer. What I feel like what it does is it covers the entire surface equally. So like if I were to take my ink pad and turn it upside down and try to ink it, I always leave a spot or two not inked as well. So by using a brayer, it covers the entire stamp really well. What I do is turn it sideways like this because the brayer fits on there a little bit better. And then I just ink it up going in one direction and then rolling the ink on the background stamp. I will warn you, if you're too aggressive, you could flip this ink pad right over and then get ink on everything. I have done that a couple times. So, yesterday, in fact. And since I'm covering up this spot, it's okay that I got ink in there, but if you were gonna stamp a greeting inside there, be careful. Or you could wipe it out, but I'm not gonna do that. Okay, so now I'm just going to lay my card, position it right here, and flatten it. And then I'm just gonna take another piece of my grid paper and then rub it. And that should be good. So now we're gonna take the 1 3/4 circle punch and position that there. Now, if you're wondering on this card, because what I did was I positioned the crumb cake on top of the early espresso, what I did was I punched it out of the crumb cake first, then attached that layer to here, and then punched it again after it was attached to the cardstock, okay? So now let's sponge this thing. I'm going to use the early espresso steel. I can't wait to show you the shimmer paint part. It just really makes the card. And then I also come inside here and where I punched out the center, and I sponge that as well. Okay, I think that looks good. And then we'll go ahead and sponge this. And if you wanted the 25 to pop a little more, because it's pretty light, you could re-stamp this and just punch it out. Let's see. Okay, what we'll do is go ahead and tie the crochet trim. Because I'm okay getting the shimmer paint on this. It doesn't bother me. Okay, there's that. And then now let's do this piece right up here. Okay, what I'm gonna first do is, this is dirty from when I used it yesterday, so I wanna show you how I clean it. If I use the stamping mist, it doesn't really get it clean exactly the way I need it to, so I'm actually gonna use a baby wipe and make sure it's totally clean. And then now I'm gonna dry it. Okay, so the first step is I'm going to stamp the greeting because it's the larger of the two, because I want to center the seasons over the greetings. Hope I worded that right. I think I did. Okay, so I've stamped greetings. Now I'm cleaning it off again and drying it. Now I'm going to ink Seasons. I think I got a piece of ink right there on the G. If you do, I'll show you a way to fix it. It doesn't look too bad. I smudged it just a tad. But if you look really close to this one, I accidentally got the G a little bit over here. So what I did was I took this whole entire piece and just plopped it right here after it had dried for a little bit. And then it pulled in just a tiny bit of the background, but just faintly. So you can cover up your mistakes. Long story short. Okay, so now let's punch this out. And I probably should have raised that up a tad. Okay, I could fix it, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to pretend it looks good, okay? I want to fix it, but... And probably what I should have done, because I think that's what I did on this one, is I went ahead and punched this, because now that we can see where we're stamping it, it worked just fine. Okay, so I am going to do this, because I like that look. See how it just gave it just a little bit? I like that. Okay, we're going to use the same punch, and we're going to punch out a piece of Early Espresso. And what I'm going to do is cut it in half and then cut these little pieces off. I don't know how other people do this. This is just how I figured it out. Okay, so what I'm going to do is apply adhesive right here and then attach it just like that. Okay, I can't remember if I sponged the edges. I did. Okay, and then put a dimensional on here. Or a couple, actually. One on each side. And then after we add this, we have one more step, which is the fun part. Well, two more, actually. I forgot to pop the 25 in there. So we'll add a dimensional to this as well. And you wouldn't have to use... this 25, you could actually use one of our other stamps. Okay, so the final step, let me go grab the color catcher. Okay, so here's our color catcher. And what I'm going to do is just place my card right in here, just like that. I'm kind of propping it back because I want, actually what I'll do is I'll just... push that 25 through, because I want to get some shimmer on that as well. Okay, so then I'm going to position it right in there, just like that. And then this is just, I've poured, I put rubbing alcohol in here, and then just poured a little bit of the Champagne Mist shimmer paint, okay? And then hold your... bottle like back here. You don't want to spray right here or you're just going to get it globbed up everywhere. So I'm just going to spray back here. You can barely see where I'm at. See my finger right here? Okay. Okay. And now look. Now that will dry. And it won't take very long because it's alcohol and the paint. See how pretty? I love it. So there you go. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks a lot. Bye.